2 of Europe Remembers on tour in the Ardennes. It's cold, it's snowing. Joël, what's the plan today?
We're going to visit the Bozjak Forest at Foy, and we're going to meet some actors of the Band of Brothers. We're going to visit the Le Mans 101st Airborne Museum. But first, we're going to the Bastogne War Museum.
All right, let's go.
Let's go.
Avec Mathieu Billa à l'intérieur de l'exposition du Bastogne-Bois Museum. Mathieu, racontez-nous un petit peu l'histoire de ce lieu, de ce musée.
Donc en fait, le musée ici a été inauguré en mars 2014. Auparavant, il y avait déjà un musée ici qui a été construit dans les années 70, mais qui était totalement remis à neuf donc, dans les années 2000 pour créer véritablement un nouveau centre de mémoire. Et l'objectif ici, c'est de présenter ce qui s'est passé dans la région, à Bastogne, mais sur l'ensemble de l'Ardenne, dans le contexte plus large de la Seconde Guerre mondiale.
Alors, racontez-nous un peu cette exposition qui effectivement commence dès 1914 et qui suit après l'ensemble de la Seconde Guerre mondiale et la bataille des Ardennes, évidemment.
En fait, on découvre l'histoire de cette Seconde Guerre depuis... d'origine vraiment, comme vous l'avez signalé, avec la fin de la Première Guerre. Et cela se fait à travers le regard de quatre personnages qui sont véritablement les guides. Ce sont quatre personnages qui s'expriment à travers l'audio guide que le visiteur reçoit. L'avantage de ces personnages, c'est qu'ils permettent aux visiteurs d'être vraiment s'identifier à eux et que ça nous permet aussi de présenter les différents points de vue, la vision, je vais dire, transversale de l'histoire. Donc on a autant le point de vue des militaires américains que des militaires allemands, mais aussi des civils, en l'occurrence une jeune femme qui fait partie de la résistance, mais aussi d'un enfant. Comment les enfants vivent la guerre? Ils ont souvent été oubliés dans l'historiographie, et donc là, ici, on veut vraiment présenter comment ça se passe.
Mathieu, on est maintenant devant le monument du Mardasson. Racontez-nous un peu l'histoire de ce mémorial américain.
Donc en fait, c'est un mémorial qui a été créé juste après la guerre. La première pierre a été posée ici sur la colline du Mardasson le 4 juillet 1946, date symbolique, qu'on est juste après la guerre. Et le mémorial en question, qui se trouve derrière nous, a été inauguré, lui, en 1950. Et donc, il est dédié vraiment aux libérateurs américains qui se sont battus pendant la fameuse bataille des Ardennes, the Battle of the Bulge.
We're now in Bozjak Woods, and during the Battle of the Bulge, around Bastogne, the 101st Airborne Division, the Easy Company, held their ground here in this forest.
So here we're in a foxholes. Can you tell us the function of this place?
This is a foxhole. It's protected for shelling because the Germans also shelled that place with 88 grenades. So yeah, this is only your protection. And it was terrible weather, winter. Brutal conditions for the men of the Easy Company, and also famous from the series The Band of Brothers. How is it for you to be here, Shane Taylor?
Well, very humbled, very honored. I've been to Bastogne a few times, and the Bozjak in particular, and there's always a great atmosphere to the place, and there's a real connection every time that we kind of come to here.
And how is it for you to be here as an actor of the Band of Brothers?
Cold.
Yeah.
No, that's exactly what Shane says. We're getting the genuine experience now with the cold and the rain and the snow, and we're here for like 30 minutes, then we're going to go back inside again, you know? And these guys were here for a long time in the snow with 88 shells firing in, so yes, it's very humbling. A little bit scary if you can imagine these things exploding all around you.
Your grandfather fought here, or was a medic here, so it's so special.
It's very special. My grandfather was Doc Rowe, at this point he was the only medic that had made it from D-Day. The other medics were replacements, so he would have been the only medic that had been with the company just after Tekoa had made the jump on D-Day and been through Holland and now was here and was the senior medic for the guys.
And did your father or the grandfather also tell you stories, or did you hear stories?
No, he didn't. He wouldn't talk. There was a few happy stories that he would tell, but nothing of the bad, nothing of the what he saw and endured, like so many of those men.
And how was it for you to see the episode of the Band of Brothers? Because your portrait of your father was...
Yeah.
was you know?
You know, it was tough. You know, there's one part where Roe is in a foxhole and they're being shelled, and I think it was Lipton who's calling, you know, medic, Roe, and Shane's there and he's not moving, and I thought they're showing him as a coward, and so I was very hurt, and I went back and watched it again, and I listened to other people, and they said that's not what they showed at all. They showed him being human and being afraid, but yet jumping up and going, which is the true sign of courage. Courage is not a lack of fear. Courage is action in spite of fear. And so I think it really showed the humanity that these men had to endure. They were scared and they were cold and they were wet and they were tired, but still they got up and fought, and that's the heroics of it.
Joel, where are we now?
This is the German war cemetery in Rocogne, and it is really important to show the different perspectives from a battle, because also young German soldiers laying here and were killed during the Battle of the Bulge.
How many soldiers are buried here?
6,800 German soldiers in the age of 16 till 52. I'm standing here together with Hans van Kessel and Johnny Bona here in the 101st Airborne Museum here in Bastogne. Hans van Kessel, you're a Dutchman, founded this museum here in Bastogne. What is the story?
The story is I came to Bastogne and I met Johnny Bona and Frank Otelet. We three have the 101st Airborne Museum. And Johnny and Frank had a kind of dream. They say, hey, we have to develop something new in Bastogne. I was interested immediately. And at that time, this building came for sale. And I said, whoa, I have a construction company in Holland. I said, this building is an historical military building. If you want to do something, we have to do it here. We have to preserve also this building, because it would be a shame if it become a lawyer office or something. So that's why we're standing here.
Okay. And Johnny, what can people see here in this museum?
People can see here a lot of stuff, artifacts and displays concerning the Battle of Bastogne and the chapter Battle of the Bulge.
Okay, and I see a lot of mannequins dressed with original clothes from the Second World War. What are the unique pieces here in this museum?
Yes, I'd say several unique pieces here, but mostly the mannequins are very realistic, and that makes more emotional and feelings here in that museum.
Hélène, we are here in the main room of the MES, the Airborne, the 101st Airborne Division Museum. How is place important for you?
Well, it's been important for me since the moment that I stepped into it. I was amazed that in Bastogne there's a place that from the beginning unified the Americans, the Belgians, and also the Germans, because they were occupying here also with their officers. And right now it's for me the heartbeat of the town, I must say, because it attracts so many active military and they find solace here, and I'm happy to be a part of that.
And this weekend, we call it the Nuts Weekend, we celebrate the 75th anniversary of the Battle of the Bulge, the beginning. How is it important for you to, one, to be present, and two, to see all these people around coming to the museum, coming to the events?
Yeah, I mean, I think what's amazing is that it has not stepped into a kind of a feeling of tourism or not taking it seriously. There's a reverence here among everybody. And if they didn't have it before they came, they feel it as soon as they cross into the town. Don't know.